Hello everyone and welcome back to Microsoft Dynamics 365 CRM plugin development course. In this video we are going to learn everything about shared variables in Dynamics 365. So ladies and gentlemen, my name is Abhishek Doria and you are watching Dynamics Academy YouTube channel. Having said that, subscribe to Dynamics Academy and press the bell icon on your YouTube app to never miss a video from Dynamics Academy.
Microsoft Dynamics 365 Customer Engagement Platform and the Execution Pipeline provides you an ability to pass data from one plugin to another plugin. How this is achieved? This is achieved via one of the iPlugin execution context property, which is called shared variable. And this property is a collection of key value pairs. Using that property, you can pass data from one plugin to another plugin when a plugin is registered on both pre-event and post-event. So what are the benefits of using shared variable? You can pass any value from pre-event to post-event of a plugin. Another benefit of shared variable is it avoids storing a temporary values into a custom attribute. And another place where certain data validations which needs to be done at the post-event and can be achieved by passing a value from pre-event of the plugin. So let us now understand the limitations of shared variable. One of the limitations of shared variable is that for a plugin registered in stage 20 or 40 of plugin execution pipeline, to access a shared variables from stage 10 plugin that executes on create, update or delete or by any retrieve exchange request, then you must access the parent context.shared variable collection. For all other cases, iPlugin execution context.shared variable contains the collection. So what it tells you is that whenever you want to pass the value from stage 10 to stage 20 or 40, then in order to get that value, you need to use parent context.shared variable collection for create, update, delete, or for retrieve exchange rate request messages. While for all other messages, you can get that value that is being passed from stage 10 to 20 or 40 by using I execution context.shared variable. So that simply means that for create, update, delete and retrieve exchange rate request plugins, if you are passing a shared variable from stage 10 to 20 or 40, then you have to check the parent context, not the plugin execution context. I hope it is clear now. The other limitation that shared variable is having is that one cannot share variable between steps using different messages and or entities, even if one triggers the other.
For example, you cannot share variables from an account create plugin to an contact update plugin,
even if your plugin code triggers the plugin on contact. So let us now understand with the help of a live example. So for this, I am creating a new plugin, pre-operation account plugin, and another plugin called post-operation account plugin. I'm copying some standard line of code from previous plugins, and the same standard line of code I am placing in the post-operation plugin as well. Text.stage is 40. Right, getting the context. On create message, my target is of account. I'm getting the service object, and in this case my stage is 20, that is pre-operation stage. And in the post-operation class, post-operation account class, everything remains same except my stage is 40, right? What I'm going to do is I'm going to pass, calculate some of the data from my pre-operation and pass that information to my post-operation, and that will see how it is getting updated. What I'm going to do, I'm going to register two plugins, one on pre-operation and one on post-operation. So in my pre-operation plugin, I will do a data validation, and where I am going to capture the account name and append it with the today's date by separating with an hyphen, and append a text called pre. This calculation I am performing in my pre-operation plugin, and whatever the value that is being generated, I will pass that value into my post-operation, and in post-operation I am going to put this value in the description field. So I hope you got the scenario. Pre-operation plugin, I am going to calculate the string, and in post-operation I am going to update the description field of that account with whatever the value that has been calculated in my pre-operation plugin. This is my pre-operation plugin. The context stage is 20. So I am going to first capturing the name of the account that will be captured in the calculated string. Now I'm again appending today's date and with hyphen pre as a postfix. Now I'm performing this calculation in the pre-operation plugin. So now I need to pass this value from pre-operation plugin to post-operation plugin. How you can do context.sharedvariables.add, you can choose whatever the key name that you want to pass. You have to use the same exact key whenever you are receiving this information in your post operation plugin. So with this you are adding a shared variable to the context string. Let us now receive that information. First, what we are capturing is, we are capturing whatever the value that is passed from pre-operation plugin to this, and the rest code we have already seen that you can update the description field with the whatever the value that you have received, and we are updating that account. We'll just now quickly register it and then we'll see this in an action. Now you can see that I have registered a plugin on pre-operation and created a step. At the same time you can see post-operation plugin. So now we will create an account. As you can see, I have created an account with name account 8. It is created successfully. And in the description, you can see that account 8 hyphen today's date and hyphen pre has been written successfully. Where in my post operation, I am updating that field, but here I have never calculated that string. In my pre-operation I have calculated that string, but I am not updating that field in my pre-operation. So what it proves that you are calculating the string in pre-operation, adding that to shared variable, that shared variable is captured in your post operation, and then you are updating that field. So I hope now you are able to understand how you can pass data from one plugin to another plugin. That's the end of this video. In our next video, we will see what is impersonation in plugin. Thanks for watching this video and see you in next video.
I thank you for watching this video till the end. So if you have learned something new out of this video, then please like, share and subscribe to Dynamics Academy. And also press the bell icon so that you will never miss any update whenever we release a new video to our Dynamics Academy YouTube channel. And on that note, I end this video and take your leave. Hope to see you all in the next video. Till then, bye-bye and take care. And once again, thank you for your time.